Well, let someone shout hallelujah.
Let somebody shout hallelujah.
Shake hand with one or two people and tell them God is going to surprise you this month.
Make you shake hand with one or two people. Make you tell them and say God will surprise you this month.
And then you may please be seated.
And make una sit down.
Deuteronomy chapter 8 from verse 10 to 18.
Deuteronomy chapter 8 verse 10 go reach 18.
Deuteronomy 8:10-18.
Deuteronomy chapter 8 verse 10 go reach 18.
When thou hast eaten and art full.
When you don't eat and you come belly full.
That means you are going to eat and you are going to be full.
It can mean say you go eat and you go belly full.
Then thou shalt bless the Lord thy God.
Then you will come bless the Lord your God.
For the good land which he has given thee.
For this good land when he don't give you.
Beware.
Make you there careful.
That thou forget not the Lord thy God.
Say you can't forget your Lord your God.
In not keeping his commandments.
You're not going to keep his commandments.
And his judgments.
And his judgments.
And his statutes.
And his statutes.
Which I command thee this day.
Which I don't command you this day.
Lest when thou hast eaten and are full.
Make it not be so when you don't eat and you don't full.
And hast built goodly houses.
And you don't build better house.
And dwell therein.
And you can't stay inside.
And when thy herds and thy flocks multiply.
And when your cow, your goat, your fowl don't increase, they don't multiply.
And thy silver and thy gold is multiplied.
And your silver and your gold don't multiply.
And all that thou hast is multiplied.
And everything you get don't multiply.
Then thy heart be lifted up.
Then your heart can't be lifted up.
And thou forget the Lord thy God.
And you can't forget your Lord your God.
Which brought thee forth out of the land of
Egypt.
Not going
to bring you out from the land of Egypt.
From the house of bondage.
From the house where the Lord take you as slave before.
Who led thee through that great and terrible wilderness.
When God take you past that wilderness when they make person they fear.
Wherein were fiery serpents.
Yeah, serpents when they frighten person day.
And scorpions.
And scorpions.
And drought. Where there was no water.
And land where not get water.
Who brought thee forth out of the rock of flint.
When God can bring water from rock.
Who fed thee in the wilderness with manna.
When God feed you for inside wilderness with the food when they call manna.
Where thy fathers knew not.
Where your papa and your mama don't know before.
That he might humble thee.
So that your feet humble you.
And that he might prove thee.
And he will come show
to
you.
To do thee good.
Say he won't do good for you.
At the latter end.
Even for this latter end.
And thou say in thy heart.
And you can't say for your heart.
My power and the might of my hand has gotten me this wealth.
Save the power and the skill of my hand. And if he get this plenty money and this good thing.
But thou shalt remember the Lord thy God.
But in good same you remember the Lord your God.
For it is he that giveth thee power to get wealth.
Because now he not give you power to make wealth.
That he may establish his covenant which is swear unto thy fathers as it is this day.
So that he will establish the covenant when he don't make with your father as it can be this day.
This month we are talking about victorious grace.
This month now victorious grace will they talk about?
It takes grace. To prosper.
It takes grace for someone to prosper.
Because business is spiritual warfare.
Because business is spiritual warfare.
Particularly for the Christian.
For Christian particularly.
The devil doesn't care if the sinner prospers.
The devil not sin. If sinners prosper.
Doesn't bother him at all.
He not trouble him at all.
If you are making money through wicked means, doesn't bother the devil.
If they make money through wicked ways, not they trouble the devil at all.
He knows the Bible.
He knows the Bible well.
He knows what is written in Jeremiah 17 verse 11.
You know what is the right for Jeremiah chapter 17 verse 11.
Jeremiah 17 verse 11.
Jeremiah chapter 17 verse 11.
The word of God says, as a partridge lays eggs.
Word of God can't say, as that bird when they call partridge can't lay eggs.
And hatch them not.
And enough he hatch them.
So with those who get wealth, but not by the right means.
So be those people when make words and they not follow the better way.
We die suddenly in the midst of their days.
They can't die as they won't start to enjoy.
And at the end will be a fool.
And at the end people will call them fool.
So it doesn't matter to the devil. If you are a sinner and you are making money, it's no problem. You are just like an Ileya ram.
It no matter to the devil. If you be sinner, you dey make money, go tell you say no problem. You go say just be like that ram when they won't kill. For Muslim festival period, Ileya.
Being fattened for the slaughter.
When we say that they feed so that he go fat, he go reach them to keep for that day.
He knows what God said in Psalm 92 verse 7.
He knows what God talked for Psalm 92 verse 7.
Psalm 92 verse 7.
Psalm 92 verse 7.
He said, when you see the wicked flourishing like a flower.
He said, when you come see the wicked people, they make up for life. They all be like a flower.
Getting rich, becoming great, is so that he will be destroyed at the end.
Then they get rich, then they become great. He said, all those things, they happen so that they go feed, destroy them. Last.
The devil knows that.
The devil knows that one.
So he doesn't care about the sinner.
So the devil not care about the sinner.
Getting rich. Doesn't bother him.
He not bother the devil about the sinner. He not bother him.
He knows the Bible.
He knows the Bible.
He knows what is written in Mark chapter 8, verse 36.
He knows what they write for Mark chapter 8, verse 36.
Mark 8, 36. Where Jesus Christ himself said. What does it profit a man?
What will be the profit of a man?
If he gains the whole world.
If he gains the whole world.
And loses his own soul.
And he can't lose his own soul.
So the devil doesn't care if the sinner prospers.
The devil not sin if the sinner can't prosper.
He knows he has his soul.
He knows say he don't already get his sinner's soul.
Let him enjoy a little bit before he comes to hell.
You will say, well, make you just enjoy a little bit before you come here.
But in the name that's above every other name, none of you will go to hell.
And the name went big past every other name. None of you will go hell.
And the devil knows the Bible.
The devil, he knows the Bible.
He knows that if the Christian prospers.
The devil knows that if the Christian prospers.
True Christian, not a pretender.
True Christian, not a 419 Christian or Wayo Christian.
If a true Christian prospers,
he knows if the true Christian prosper,
the work of the kingdom of God will be easily done.
God's work will go one with ease.
He knows that.
You know that one.
He knows God said in Zechariah chapter 1 verse 17.
You know what God talked for Zechariah chapter 1 verse 17.
Zechariah 1 verse 17.
Zechariah 1 verse 17.
That my city shall yet be built through prosperity.
Say God will build his city with true prosperity.
Throughout the whole world.
Throughout the whole world.
He knows if the Christian prospers.
He knows a good Christian prosper.
The gospel will be preached throughout the whole world.
This gospel of Christ will preach them throughout the whole world.
Churches will be built throughout the whole world. He knows that.
They will build church all around the world. The devil know that one.
And so, he goes all out to attack a Christian financially.
Come make the devil come out with full force to come attack the finance of Christians.
Either it will cause the Christian to labor in vain.
Either it will cause the Christian make he come labor and get nothing to show for him.
Like in Luke chapter 5.
Like in Luke chapter 5.
You can read it from verse 1 to 7.
If you read that from 1 to 7.
Luke 5 verse 1 to 7.
Luke chapter 5 verse 1 go reach 7.
Peter fished all night and caught nothing.
Peter can't fish all night. He can't catch nothing.
And there are several people who walk all night and there's nothing to show for it.
Yeah, get many people when they walk all night, they don't get anything to show for this labor.
But that's going to change this morning.
But that one will change this morning.
He knows.
The devil knows.
That if he can just attack your finances.
Say if he attack your finances,
the work of God will be slowed down.
The work of God will be slow.
But here grace comes in.
For here grace can show face.
It takes grace of God to become, for God to become your partner.
Now God grace so for one to become God's partner.
When you read the story in Luke chapter 5, verse 1 to 7.
When you read the story for Luke chapter 5, verse 1, go read 7.
Luke 5, verse 1 to 7.
Luke chapter 5, verse 1, go read 7.
There were two sheep by the shore.
Now two sheep not there by the shore.
It was grace that chose Peter's boat.
Then a grace not going to choose Peter's boat.
I am praying today that when God decides to choose a business to partner with, it will be your own.
And they pray today, say, if God they look for business when you want partner with, that one will be your business.
Oh, somebody will say, well, but after Peter flourished, he beckoned to the second sheep to come and help.
Some people will say, well, after Peter called catch many fish, he can't call the other sheep, may they come assist them.
I say, yes, sir.
I can't tell them, say, yes, sir.
I prefer to be the one who will have the surplus.
Then me, oh, I prefer to be the person who is supposed to get the surplus.
Who will be calling others to come and help?
I go call, they call other people to come help them.
What about you?
What about you?
So the devil tries to attack your resources.
So the devil, you can't try to attack your resources.
Stealing, killing, destroying.
You won't steal. Go on kill, go on destroy.
Until the Lord comes in to restore.
Until Jesus Christ can come inside, can restore.
John chapter 10, verse 10.
John 10, 10.
John chapter 10, verse 10.
John 10, 10.
The Bible says the devil comes to, but not, I mean, the thief cometh not but for to steal, to kill, and to destroy.
He said the thief, oh, he come not can do anything than to kill, to steal and to destroy.
But thank God, he said, I have come that you may have life and have it more abundantly.
But thank God, though, Jesus Christ saying, don't come so that we will get life and we will get the life you have been.
The devil tries to slow down your progress.
The devil, they try to slow down your progress
by moving you against God Himself.
You can't try to move you against God Himself.
He knows that if God is on your side, he can't defeat you.
The devil no say, if God is your side, him himself no go fit defeat you.
So he tries to cause you to come against God himself.
So he can't try to cause you, may you come against God yourself.
Remember in Joshua chapter 6.
Remember for Joshua chapter 6.
Verse 20. Joshua 6 verse 20.
Verse 20, Joshua chapter 6, verse 20.
The children of Israel shouted only one hallelujah and the wall of Jericho fell.
The children of Israel, now only one hallelujah they shout and the wall of Jericho fall down.
Then in Joshua chapter 7.
Therefore, Joshua chapter 7.
They went against a small town called Ai.
They can't go against one small town, what they call Ai.
And they were defeated.
That people of Ai, they defeated them.
Why?
What is the reason?
Because if you read it from that Joshua chapter 7, verse 1 to 12.
Because when you read that from Joshua chapter 7, verse 1, go reach 12.
Somebody has stolen what belonged to God.
One of them, God still what it be God own.
God said, everything you find in Jericho, bring to my house.
God said, everything you want to see for Jericho, mona bring I come my house.
But somebody went and stole what belonged to God.
But one person can't go. Go thief what it be God own.
As a result, the people who were victorious before became losers.
By so doing, people when they're victorious before, all of them can't be losers.
You will not be a loser in Jesus' name.
I pray, say, you're not going to be a loser in Jesus' name.
Whether you know it or not, the devil knows Malachi chapter 3.
Whether you know him or not, the devil in Malachi chapter 3.
He has read it long ago.
He don't read that many, many years ago.
He knows that God says in verse 8 to 11.
You know what God talk for verse 8, go reach 11.
Verse 8 to 11.
Verse 8, go reach 11.
That if you rob God.
Say if you steal from God.
of his tithes, of his offerings.
If you steal God tithes, steal God offerings.
God said there in verse 11.
God can talk say for verse 11.
That is the one who himself will now send an army of devourers.
He can talk say him himself, God, I go send army when we say they destroy and they take things.
The devil says, I don't have to worry about you anymore.
The devil can't say, well, I don't need to worry again.
All you need to do is fail to pay your tithe, fail to give your offering. Then
all what I go feel do is to make you fail to pay your tithe, fail to give your offering.
The devil will just stand by and begin to laugh.
Yeah, the devil can't stay one side, you can't start to laugh.
Because it is God now who will say, you can't steal from me and get away from it.
Because now God himself will come say, this one don't reach. You not go feel steal from me and you can't go away with that.
Or he goes a little further. He knows some of you are too wise.
Or you can't take a step further because he knows some of you are wise. Well,
not to want to pay your tithe.
No, no one pay on your tithe.
He begins to tell you what exactly is tithe.
You can't tell you now. What is tithe even stand for?
What tithe is he asking you to pay?
Which type of tithe God they ask you to pay?
Is it the tithe of the gross?
I thought you were surprised your expenses. The money will remain at the tithe you go pay.
Or the tithe of the net.
Or the tithe of the whole money.
I'm sure some of you have heard that one before.
I believe some of you have heard that one before.
How much is it that God is asking me to pay in tithe?
How much God they ask me can pay for tithe?
Is it after I've collected my salary, am I to pay the tithe of all?
Now after I don't collect my salary, I need to pay the tithe of everything.
Or he wants me to first of all take money for house rent.
Oh, God wants me to make I take money first for house rent.
Money for food.
Money for food.
Money for transportation.
Money for transportation.
And then whatever is left.
And what you call remain? That one I'll call pay tithe off.
You know the story in Acts chapter 5.
You know the story for Acts chapter 5.
Verse 1 to 11. Acts 5 verse 1 to 11.
Verse 1 go reach 11. Acts 5 verse 1 go reach 11.
Ananias and Sapphira. They decided that they were going to bring money to the church.
Now only they thought said they won't bring money come to church.
But they divided it into two. Let's keep a little and take half.
But they can't divide the money into two parts. Like we keep part and we'll take the other part to church.
And when we get there, we'll tell them we have brought all.
And we'll tell the pastor and everybody for church, say we don't bring everything.
God is a mathematician. He knows how to calculate.
God is a mathematician. He knows how to calculate.
Or the devil may now go beyond that and just cause you to be proud.
Or the devil, if you take another step further and you can't cause me, you're very proud.
Checking God's glory.
You can't take God's glory.
Like we read in Deuteronomy 8 verse 17. Deuteronomy 8 verse 17. He said,
Like we read for Deuteronomy chapter 8 verse 17. Deuteronomy 8 verse 17.
When everything now begins to prosper, when you eat and you are full, you build houses, everything is going fine, you begin to say, I am the one who made this possible.
He said, when everything that they work out well, you don't build house, you don't stay inside, money that they flow, yamfo, things, your business, they go on. And you call the thought, say, well, now with my tactics, I take do this one.
You begin to say to yourself, my power has gotten me this wealth.
You say, my knowledge, my skills might bring me this money.
It's my brain.
See now my brain.
That manipulated the business.
That brain I used to do this business when I get this money.
It's my brain that brought me to this job.
See now because I know book well, that make me take get this job.
It's my achievement. You begin to say it's me.
Continue tossing now because of me. What here I get? What here I be?
The devil knows what he's doing.
The devil knows what he do.
He knows the Bible.
The devil knows the Bible.
He know it is written in James chapter 4 verse 6. James chapter 4 verse 6 that God receives the proud.
The devil knows the Bible. He know what he write for James chapter 4 verse 6. James 4 verse 6. That God they push the person who is proud go one side.
The moment you become proud, God begins to resist. You don't want to fight God.
The moment when you come there proud, God go they push you go corner. I believe you don't want to fight God.
And the moment pride comes, the moment you begin to say, it is my strength that produce this result.
The moment pride come, you can't touch now by my strength, they produce this thing.
It's my wisdom.
Not by my wisdom.
It's my ability.
Not by my ability.
It becomes difficult to honor God.
It go hard way for you to come honor God.
It becomes difficult to give God the glory due to His name.
It go hard for you to give God the glory when it's supposed to be for God's name.
That's why He wants us this morning.
That make it a warn us this morning.
And I believe that God is bringing this message because there is going to be dramatic changes for the better in the life of someone.
I believe God they taught this word because there will be great change from bad to good for one person's life this morning.
He said you must remember.
The Bible taught say you must remember.
Remember.
He wants you make you remember.
That it is God who gives you the power to get wealth.
He wants me you remember saying that God will not give you that power make you take your wealth.
God. And God alone.
Now God and God alone.
Oh, no, sir. You got it wrong. I studied.
It was a, oh, God, you get it wrong. Oh, me, I go school well. I read my book well.
I got 3 degrees.
Now 3 degrees I get.
That's why I'm appointed CEO.
That means they can't appoint me as the owner of this company.
La lie.
Now lie be that.
There are professors who became mad.
Professors though will not be Christmen.
Don't forget that one.
Make you not forget that one.
I've told you stories about that before.
I not telling a story about that one before.
I have been in the academic.
I don't their school settings for long.
I have seen professors who can't even remember anything at all.
I don't see professor one of you remember anything at all.
I've seen professors who can't even remember the name of their wives.
I don't see professor one of you remember the name of their wives.
Don't joke with God.
Make you not joke with God. Who?
Your brain is in His hands.
Your brain are God and it is.
Oh, it's my power.
If it was a hole, not my power.
It's my ability.
Not my ability.
That got me this strength.
That can't give me this strength.
That got me this wealth.
That can't give me this wealth.
God demonstrated it to one of my boys who, thank God, had enough wisdom to run back to God quickly.
God can show this to one of my boys. Thank God, say, get wisdom. He can't run, come back, God, quickly.
He was bringing in a shipload of rice.
They carry sheep, come, went full with rice, come Nigeria.
A whole sheep.
The whole sheep, they filled with rice.
And for reason nobody can explain, by the time they landed in Lagos and they enter to begin to bring the bag of rice, they found everything soaked in water.
For one reason or the other, when nobody will feel explained, by the time the ship reached Lagos and laborers won't offload the ship, they find and say all the bag of rice don't wet with water.
And the boat wasn't leaking.
But the boat not a leak.
When you succeed because God made you successful. Do I hear amen to somebody?
When you succeed because God now make you successful. I feel hear amen for one person.
It is only when you realize that it is the grace of God.
Only when you can't reason that. Say now by God's grace.
That gives you the power to get wealth.
I give you power, may you feel get wealth.
That it becomes easy to honor God.
You can't be easy for you to feel honor God. With your first fruit.
Proverbs chapter 3, verse 9 to 10.
Proverbs chapter 3, verse 9, go reach 10.
Proverbs 3, 9 to 10.
Proverbs 3, 9, go reach 10.
When he say honor God with your first fruit.
When God say make you honor God with your first fruit.
With your substance and with the first fruit of your increase.
With your substance and the first fruit of your increase.
He is saying, just remember, without me, this will not happen.
He say make you just remember, say, without him, God, this thing not going to happen.
When I was very young.
When are they very young?
Living with my father in a little farm.
I can't live with my father for one little farm like that.
Around June, when the first yam is coming.
Around June, when we harvest the first yam.
My father will take the best of the yam, first one.
My father will come select the best yam out of the first one when we harvest,
before we taste any,
before we eat any of the
I
yam,
say, take it to the catechist. It was catechist we had then before we began to have reverend.
You can't tell us more, carry go give the catechist. Because now catechist we get that time before we can't start to get reverend.
And I will look at the yam. Why?
I can't look this yam. I can't talk for my mind. See, why my papa they do this thing?
We haven't even tasted it. I said, take it. Just take it to the church.
We don't want to eat any of this yam. My papa go talk, say, carry this thing, go give church.
Say, that one belongs to God.
But I say, this yam, it belongs to God.
One day, as young as I was, I asked him, why?
One day, as a small rich, I can ask my papa, say, why you they do this kind of thing?
He told me, number one, it is God who caused the rain to fall.
He can't tell me, say, number one, that God might cause the rain, make it fall.
Number two is the one who gave me health to be able to even plant and go through.
He said, number two, now God now can't give me the good health when I can't say plant, can't weed, can't feed harvest.
Number three, I could be dead by now.
Because say number three, I for not die before now.
Number four, if I don't show my gratitude now, I may not be around next year.
Because say number four, if I not show say I'm grateful to God, I feel not day around next year.
Who gives you the power to get? Well,
who can give you the power make you make money?
God.
Nah, God.
Stand on your feet.
Make us stand on our feet.
Lift your voice to the Almighty God loud and clear and say, Father.
Lift your voice to the Almighty God and to say, Father.
From now on.
From now on.
I will honor you.
I go honor you.
Go ahead, talk to the Almighty God.
Make us go ahead and talk to the Almighty God.
From now on.
From now on.
I will honor you.
I go honor you.
I will honor you in every area. I will show you that I appreciate the fact.
I go honor you for every area. I go show you, say I appreciate you.
Without you, I am nothing.
Except without you, I be nothing.
Without you, I can't become anything that I am today.
Now without you, I not go fit be anything when I be today.
It is not my power.
Not by my power.
It's not my strength.
Not by my strength.
It's not my ability.
Not by my ability.
It is you.
Not by you.
It is you.
Not by you, Lord.
And I will honor you.
And I go honor you.
I will honor you, Lord.
I go honor you, Lord.
I will honor you, Almighty God. I will honor you.
I go honor you, Lord, Almighty God. I go honor you. I go honor you.
From now on.
From now on.
I will show my appreciation. I will honor you.
I go show, say, I appreciate you. I go honor you.
I will honor you, Lord.
I go honor you, Lord.
I will honor you all the days of my life.
I will honor you all the days of my life.
I will honor you.
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 For the rest of my life.
For the remaining days of my life.
I will honor you.
I will honor you.
Because you are the only one. It's your grace.
Because it's not by your grace.
That can give me power.
You will give me power.
To get wealth.
To come make wealth.
It is your grace. Your grace and your grace alone.
Not by your grace. And not by your grace and your grace alone.
Your grace.
And not by your grace.
And your grace alone.
And your grace alone.
Whatever I can ever be, whatever I can become.
What I go ever be? What I go ever become?
Whatever I am now.
What I be now?
It's your grace and your grace alone.
And your grace. And your grace alone.
Your grace and your grace alone.
And your grace and your grace alone.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father.
In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
In Jesus' mighty name, we don't pray.
Before we pray our next prayer, and please remain in an attitude of worship.
Before we pray our next prayer, make we remain in the attitude of worship.
The best thing you can do more than anything else is, of course, to honor him with your life.
The best thing for one to do more than anything in life that will honor God with your life.
So if you are here and you have not already surrendered your life to Jesus Christ, come and do it this morning.
So if you're there, you know what, submit your life to the Lord Jesus Christ, but you can't do them this morning.
The reason you haven't succeeded is because you have been claiming that you are the owner of your life.
The reason why you know what succeed now, because you claim, so now you get your life.
That's why I say, all right, hand it and let us see how far you can go.
Now me can say, okay, hand on ram, we'll see how far you can go.
Come and surrender your life to Jesus Christ now.
Come surrender your life to Jesus Christ.
I'm not going to wait for you. We will continue with our prayers.
I'm not going to wait for you. We'll continue with our prayers.
The rest of us, let's lift our voices to God and say, Father.
The rest of us, we'll lift our voices to Lord Almighty. We'll say, Father.
I commit my future into your hands.
I commit my future into your hands.
Let it be well. Let it be well.
Make it day better.
Let it be well.
Make it day better.
Let it be well.
Make it day better. Oh.
I'm tired of struggling.
I'm not tired of the struggle.
And having nothing to show for it, I commit my future into your hands, O Lord.
I'm not got anything to show for it. I commit my future into your hands, O Lord.
Let it be well.
Make it day better.
Those of you who want to give your life to Jesus, hurry up.
Those who want to give your life to Jesus Christ, when I already come.
So that I can pray for your salvation today.
So have you pray for your salvation today.
Come quickly and pray as you come, asking Jesus to forgive you.
They're going
to
come quickly. I'm going to pray as they come. When they tell God, may God forgive you.
To accept you.
Make He accept you.
To give you a brand new beginning.
Make He give you a brand new beginning.
Come, the Lord is calling you.
They're going to come. The Lord Jesus will call you.
Let this day be your own day of salvation.
Let this day be your own day of salvation.
First thing you can do is surrender your life to Him.
The best thing for you to do is to surrender your life to Him.
Surrender your life to Him.
It's for you to surrender your life to Jesus.
Let Him save your soul.
Let Jesus save your soul.
That life is not your own. Come and surrender it to the owner.
That life not be your own. Make you come surrender to the owner.
Ask Jesus to be merciful to you.
Tell Jesus, may He be merciful to you.
To forgive all your sins.
Make He forgive you of your sins.
And to give you a brand new beginning.
And make He give you a brand new beginning.
Tell Him you will serve Him from now on.
Tell Him, say you go serve Him from now on.
Tell Him you are surrendering your life, your entire life.
Tell Him, say you surrender your whole life.
Unto Him.
Unto Ram.
Say, Father, have mercy on me.
Say, Father, have mercy on me.
Take over my life.
Take over my life.
Take over my life completely. I surrender all to you, Lord.
Take over my life completely. I surrender all my life to you completely.
Have mercy on me. Forgive all my sins, Lord.
Have mercy upon me. Forgive me all my sins, Lord.
Forgive all my sins.
Forgive me all my sins.
Save my soul and I will serve you.
Save my soul. And I go serve you.
For the rest of my life, I will serve you.
For the rest of my life, I go serve you.
For the rest of my life.
For the rest of my life.
You gave me the life, so I'm handing it back over to you, Lord.
Now you give me this life, and I give it back to you, Lord.
Save my soul.
Save my soul.
Take over completely, Lord. Take over completely.
Take over completely, Lord.
Save my soul from sin.
Save my soul from sin.
Give me a brand new beginning so I can serve you for the rest of my life.
Give me a brand new beginning so I go fit serve you for the rest of my life.
So I can serve you.
So I go fit serve you.
For the rest of my life.
For the rest of my life.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father.
In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
In Jesus' mighty name, we all pray.
Savior, we want to thank you first and foremost for your word.
Savior, we want to thank you first and foremost for your word.
We want to thank you for these people who have come forward to surrender their life to you.
We want to thank you for these people when they come surrender their life to you.
Please remember your promise that whosoever will come unto you, you will no wise cast out.
Please make you remember your promise. Say, whoever come unto you, you know, will drive them back.
They've come to you now. Please receive them in Jesus' name.
They don't come to you. Please receive them in Jesus' name.
Save their souls, Lord.
Save their souls, O Lord.
Let your blood wash away their sins.
Let your blood wash away their sins.
Write their names in the book of life.
Write their name in the book of life.
And from now on, don't let them labor in vain.
And from now on, God, don't let them labor in vain.
Anytime they call on you, answer them by fire.
Anytime they can't call on you, make you answer them by fire.
In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
In Jesus' mighty name, we all pray.
Amen.
Amen.
Oh, lift your voice to the Almighty God, louder and clear, and say, Father.
We're gonna take our voice up to the Almighty God. I'm gonna say, Father.
I surrender my all to you.
I surrender my all to you.
And so in your name.
And so in your name.
I rebuke the devil.
I rebuke the devil.
I say.
I toss it.
Satan.
Satan.
Take your hands off my finances.
Come out your hands for my money.
Go ahead, talk to the Almighty God.
Go ahead, may you talk to the Almighty God.
Father, I surrender all to you.
Father, I surrender all to you.
I ask you to be the CEO of my finances.
I ask you to be the ogre of my finance.
And so I can say, in your mighty name, the mighty name of Jesus.
So I go fit to say, in the mighty name of Jesus.
Satan.
Satan.
You take your dirty hands.
Take your dirty hand.
Of my finances.
For my finances.
I've surrendered all to God now.
I don't surrender all to God.
I will honor him in all ways.
I go honor God in all ways.
I will no longer rob him.
I go no longer the thief from God.
I will no longer play games with him.
I go no longer the play wayo with God.
So Satan, I command you, you take your dirty hands off my finances.
So Satan, I command you, take your dirty hands, come off of my finances.
Right now.
Right now.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
My money belongs to God.
My money na God get him.
He gave it to me. I will honor him.
Na God give me. I go honor God.
With all my resources.
With all my resources.
So Satan, I command you this day.
So Satan, I command you this day.
Take your dirty hands.
Take your dirty hand.
Of my finances.
Come out for my money.
Stay away.
Go far for my money.
From this hour onward.
From this hour, go far for my money.
Take your dirty hands off my finances.
Take your dirty hands for my finance.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father.
In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
In Jesus' mighty name, we'll all pray.
So shall it be in Jesus' name.
Now so it will be in Jesus' name.
Eternal Rock of Ages, we just want to bless your name.
Eternal Rock of Ages, we just want to bless your name.
Thank you because you have the ability to answer all prayers.
Thank you because you get that power to answer all prayers.
Accept our thanks in Jesus' name.
Make you accept our thanks in Jesus' name.
Whatever may be the request of your children.
What go be the request of this your children?
Those before the altar.
Those people went to the altar.
Those over there in the congregation.
Those went to the congregation.
This very day, answer us all.
This very day, may you answer every one of us.
That breakthrough that we have been believing you for.
The breakthrough one they believe you for.
Please. Give us today.
Please, may you give us today.
In this month of grace.
For this month of grace.
Every one of us.
Every one of us.
Let us find favor with you.
Make we get favor with you.
Let us find favor with men.
Make we get favor with man.
Father, long before the end of this month.
Father, long before the end of this month.
In the home of every one of us, let there be shouts of joy.
In every one of our home, we'll get shouts of joy.
Father, bless the offering of your children.
Father, may you bless the offering of your children.
Sanctify.
Sanctify the offering.
Use it for your glory.
Use it for your own glory.
And from now on.
And from now on.
In the name that's above every other name.
In the name where better pass every other name.
I decree that the devil will stay away from our finances.
I decree, say the devil will stay away from your finances.
So shall it be.
Now so it will be.
In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
In Jesus' mighty name we all pray.
Amen.
Amen.
Now who is going to honor God with the greatest shout of hallelujah?
Now who will honor God with the greatest shout of hallelujah?